Today we wrote a very precise pocket with multiple depth with no CNC. This is a hook in our bathroom that has seen already better days. I would like to replace this awful broken hook with a nice thick oak board that has several of these hooks. These hooks are designed for installation with a router and a 16mm bit or a large rubber mallet and a metal transducer. The hook sits in a 16mm wide slot that is easy to route as the lip is covering up all the mistakes. However, I don't like the aesthetic of the lip sitting proud on the surface. If your mallet doesn't feature a metal transducer, I will show you how to route the 3D shape with and without the CNC. Before getting to the routing, we have to prepare the board. I cut the board to the approximate length on the miter saw. On the jointer, I create one flat side and one straight edge. Next, I run the board through the thickness planer to get two flat surfaces. As I do have a CNC, I throw the board on the bed and let the CNC do its job. But while the CNC is working, let's look at an alternative method on how to get this job done with no CNC at hand. It all starts in the office with taking measurements and developing a CAD model in FreeCAD. In FreeCAD, we create a spreadsheet that contains all the relevant parameters. The first one might be the most important one. It is the wiggle room that we need in order to fit two pieces together. In my experience, having half a millimeter to play with, so 0.25 millimeters on either side, works quite well. Next, we have to type in the dimension of the guide bushing and the router bit we are using so that we can calculate the offset. The distance to the midpoint is how far away we want to position the hook from the edge of the board. For the first template, we need to measure the height and the width, as well as the radius of the corners. Having a radius gauge is super handy for these kind of tasks. Template 2 is much simpler as it only has a width and a height. For the third template, we only need the distance of the two screw holes. Modeling the actual shape in FreeCAD is quite simple. The first template is square with fillets, with the size increased by 2x offset and our wiggle room. This shape then becomes a cutout in a larger template. After finishing the sketch, we pad up the surface and add a small lip to register the jig against the board. The second template should later on sit in the first one, so we first create the actual template form, which consists of two half circles and two lines that are spaced by the dimensions of the spreadsheet, again adding the offset and the wiggle room. As the outer form, we produce the exact same shape as for the first template, a little bit undersized. After padding up the second template, the last one is pretty much identical regarding the outer form, just that we add this time two holes that have the diameter of our guide bushing, plus the usual wiggle distance. I sent these forms to the 3D printer with the simple macro I described in one of the last videos. If you don't have a 3D printer, you could create a drawing and cut it out on the scroll saw. I did this a lot of times before the area of 3D printing and laser cutting, and it works quite well. Let's put these prints to use on a test piece of wood. With the size of the main template, I stayed on the cheap side and printed it rather small. We have to support the sides of the template for the lack of contact surface between the jig and the board. Clamping thin support strips of ply next to it increases the stability quite a lot. We can now set the depth of the router to 1.5 mm and route away everything within the first template. As a next step, I replace template 1 by template 3 and bore the two holes all the way through the board. When the work on template 3 is finished, I just snap in the thin frame of template 2 and remove the necessary 12 mm in several passes. Let's remove the jig and see if it all fits. Like a glove, there is no gap and the hook sits perfectly flush with the surface. In the meantime, the CNC also finished its job. We can remove the dust, remove the screw and the wedge that has held the piece in place. On the table saw, I cut the board to its final width and length. As the end mill on the CNC wasn't long enough, I have to finish the mounting holes on the drill press. In order to ease the edges and make the look a little less massive, the board gets a chamfer on all four sides. With two stops on the router table and a keyhole router bit, I first route the keyhole in one side, and after changing the position of the stops, the other side gets the same treatment. The surface is after the planing already in pretty good shape, so it only needs a light hand sanding and then gets two coats of hard wax oil. Before we can put the screws into the hook, we have to counter bore for the screw heads. To do so, I use again the router and the simplest possible template. This template is a simple 17 mm hole in a scrap piece of wood. The hole is aligned with the center of the 4.5 mm holes so that we can counter bore a hole of the right size using a 10 mm bit in the router. Lastly, I apply my maker mark with the mini laser. It's really convenient that this machine does not require a connection to the computer and can be used in the workshop. Now let's hang this piece in its place. Oh, that looks much better now. If you liked the video, also have a look at the one featured that shows another great use case for the guide bushing and the router.